All right, so more and more tires these days are coming with noise-canceling foam adhered to the inner liner. And we're getting a lot of questions about it from drivers, from tire manufacturers, car manufacturers, journalists. You know, everybody wants to know, does it work?
Yeah.
Is it worth it? Because it's not free, right?
Our customers asking for it, right?
Yes, yeah. Absolutely. Yeah. Yeah. So everybody wants to know, is it worth it? And up until now, there hasn't really been much testing out there to determine the answer of, does it make a difference? So that's what we decided we're gonna do, right?
Yeah.
Right, so Michelin was kind enough to manufacture a special one-off set of Cross Climate 2s that fit our Tesla Model 3s.
Usually a tire without foam.
Correct, yeah, absolutely. Normally it comes without, but now we have two identical sets, one with foam, one without. And since these foam inside tires are typically geared towards electric vehicles, we decided to test them on our Tesla Model 3s.
Right.
So we've got, 6 days worth of testing. We are gonna do 5 days worth of range driving to see if it has an impact on the range that you can expect from a single charge on your vehicle.
We don't know what we don't know. It may. You're thinking, oh, foam, that's light, that's not gonna change range. But the adhesive, it can be kind of heavy. Who knows, maybe it'll add up. Maybe it's something we don't understand and we do see a difference in range. That's something we wanna find out.
Right, we don't know what we don't know, so we'd rather test it to find out. And in addition to range, we will do our normal road rides. So we will test ride quality, which we don't think is gonna change, steering and on-road handling, which we don't think is gonna change, and noise, which of course is the focus of the test, the primary focus of
and
the test.
And it's not just our typical subjective noise evaluation. Mm-hmm. We are gonna use a dB meter to measure the absolute objective noise level. This will actually give a stone metric that we can actually measure.
Mm-hmm. Yep, there's more to sound than just decibels. dB stands for decibels, by the way.
Oh.
Yeah, you're welcome. Yeah, and we're gonna be doing all of this testing blind. So the entire time we're testing, we're not going to know which tires are on which cars.
Right.
So you're gonna learn right along with us. We're gonna learn right along with you. Let's find out.
Okay, all HVAC off.
Mm-hmm.
Steering wheel, seat, heaters. Engaged. Hopefully they don't make any noise.
I hope not too, because if they do, that probably means they're shorting out and we're gonna be on fire.
Okay. Sounds pretty good.
Yep. Pretty good. Pretty quiet.
Over
a couple of those bumps, I heard just like a little bit of ringing resonance after the fact, but it was pretty well muted.
Yeah.
Here on this service, it also has like a small amount of just like a grindy ringing sound to me. It's a resonance, a frequency, I assume from inside the cabin of the tire, or maybe it's what's passing up through the car. But that's one thing that I want to really pay attention to with both tires, just to try to kind of figure out that might be the differentiation between the two.
Yeah, it's well controlled, but it's there.
Mm-hmm. Do you get just a little tiny bit of pitter patter kind of from down low and behind? There's also the kind of constant, but also has a touch of cyclicalness to it from the tread interacting with the surface, I assume.
But it's lower pitch, so it's doing a nice job of staying inconspicuous.
I mean, all of it is quieter than the wind noise from the mirrors. And so
I'm excited to drive the next tire.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, lower pitch too.
Yeah. There's still a little bit of the resonance on the super coarse cross-cut concrete on the bypass. I haven't heard any of that kick the basketball ring over any of the impacts that we hit every time on both tires. And either way, these are still both very quiet tires.
Close.
They are close.
Awfully close.
We'll wait and see after I drive, but my money would be on this is the
already,
foam tire.
You're making that call already.
I said we'll wait and see until after I drive. Early prediction, folks. Everybody loves bold, crazy predictions, right? That makes good television.
I feel like this is a little more muted as well. It's just, they've taken the equalizer and just lowered the noise level just a hair on that real coarse stuff.
I think so too.
Just a hair.
I like it. As soon as we change surfaces, both of us go, hang on, I have to listen harder.
Yeah. this is evened out. Mark my words, this is evened out. Whether it's foam or not foam, this sounds better on bed. They're both great. They're both great here. They're both great on our other smooth surface at 55. You're having a hard time justifying any additional cost for foam.
Yep.
Could absolutely change.
All right, so we finished our road rides. Yep. We drove spec A, then B, and repeated A.
Right.
And we both did that from the driver's seat and from the passenger seat. So we have quite a bit of experience on these tires at this point. Yep. And what did we find out?
Between the two, steering was shockingly identical.
Not shockingly, in fact, as expected.
Sarcasm meter peg. And ride, again, shockingly or not shockingly, basically identical. We couldn't really tell the difference. But noise is arguably what we thought we were gonna be testing the most. I thought maybe car B had a little less roar, a little bit lower kind of muted tones on some of the real coarse pavement. I don't know, what'd you think?
Yeah, I agree. Maybe over the coarse concrete that creates kind of that, like you said, that dull roar right. constantly. Maybe it was a little bit quieter, a little bit more muted.
Maybe.
Over impacts, you know, you get kind of that kind of kick the basketball ring over impacts, and car B potentially muted the end of that a little bit sooner.
And these are levels that are so, I don't want to say minute, but
they're
if
minute.
You had the air conditioning running or even a decent fan speed or God forbid the radio.
Yeah, or you're talking to your passenger in the passenger seat.
Yeah. Probably you wouldn't notice the difference, at least right away. Maybe if you lived with it, but I don't know.
So who knows? I mean, like you said, we had the best case scenario, testing back to back, brand new tires, so there's no irregular wear.
Right.
And it was tough for us to tell a difference.
I wouldn't say it was imperceptible because I think it was there, but I'm still kind of worried it's not B. I am still kind of worried.
Right. Yeah, our money is on the B car, is the car with the foam in it, the noise canceling foam in the tires.
We'll find out.
Yeah, let's find out. So we drove two rounds in each spec, and our two drives in spec B were identical to one another. In spec A, we found a little bit of variance that was due to traffic, you know, the surrounding traffic on the road. We have the results of our two specs.
I'm excited.
On the first portion of our road ride route, car A was between 58 and 60 decibels.
Okay.
Car B was 58 to 59 decibels. So right off the get-go, our spec B prediction, which mind you, we've never seen these before, and our spec B prediction is hopefully.
All right, we're done.
Doing it out? Yeah, that's it. Wrap it up, go home. Okay, impacts on the first section of our route. Car A was between 60 and 64 decibels, which that's one of those places that we got some interference from traffic. So we're not really solid on that number. Car B was 61. That same stretch before the bridge, they were identical. Just after that, over the bridge on the impacts, car A, again, a little bit of interference, 69 to 73 decibels. Car B, 67 to 69. So even without that spike, that 73 spike, seems like car B is a little bit better.
Yeah.
The stretch after that, they were identical.
Sure.
On the rough section of the bypass, 67 to 72 for this tire, 67 to 70 for car B. So we're doing all right here. Course section of the bypass, up to 69 on car A, only up to 67 on car B.
Okay.
The smooth section of the bypass, 64 to 66, 63 to 65 decibels.
Okay, yeah.
On Lincoln Way, they were identical. Impacts on Lincoln Way, they were identical. On Poppy, 64 to 66 decibels on car A, 63 to 65 on car B. And on Old Cleveland Road, they were identical.
Perfect. All right, so our carefully calibrated ears agree with the machines, or the machines agree with us?
Yep, okay. It still works. So a lot of places they're identical. Over impact, maybe a little bit more muted, and on some of the rougher sections, a little bit quieter. So all things look promising for our prediction coming true. We're excited for the big reveal to find out which tire's on which car.
Let's do it.
Yep. All right, Brent, here it is. Yep. The moment of truth. Our ears say car B should have the foam. The decibel meter says car B should have the foam. This is the tire off of car B. If there is a white mark on this tire, it has foam. If not, there's no foam.
There's
ready for this?
Absolutely a white mark on this tire.
Is there a white mark on this tire?
Maybe.
I haven't seen it yet. Here we go. 3, 2, 1.
Oh, baby.
Oh, foam right there.
It says foam.
It says foam.
Wow.
We knew it. We knew it all along.
I wasn't worried. I wasn't worried at all.
You were nervous. Yeah,
no.
I was
not. Yeah.
So?
Competent.
All right. So we've done 6 days of blind testing. 5 days of it was dedicated to range testing.
Right.
And we found
almost no difference. It was all within the noise of our test protocols, mm-hmm. which makes them, frankly, equivalent.
Yeah, they're close enough to be called the same.
Yeah.
Okay, great. Ride quality, no difference, as expected. Yeah. Steering and on-road handling.
No difference.
No difference, as expected. What about noise?
Both of us agreed we could find perceptible differences between the two tires.
Not huge, but perceptible.
Exactly. Yeah, very small differences. And our decibel meter agreed. The decibel meter on B read a little bit lower than it did on A. And that's the one that we both agreed upon that probably has the foam.
It's probably not going to make a huge change overnight if you apply these to your vehicle. And
it's not a magic solution to tire noise.
Right, yeah. And yeah. if your vehicle came with them from the factory, you know, the only way to maintain that exact same noise comfort is to right. go back with those. But if you want to save a few bucks, might not be a bad idea,
yeah.
right? Anyway, so it's been fun. Thanks for learning along with us. See you next time.